Thank you everybody for being here. My name is Kieran Farmer, member of the Incredibowl team. We're a senior design project here, electrical group, college engineering. All right, so we first bonded by, we all own pets, we all grew up having pets, and we all love them, we treat them as family members. Everybody knows that basically that has pets. But one problem that a lot of people face comes when you go to feed your pet. So I personally, my parents live on a ranch, so we have horses, cows, and everything. But particularly I have 5 cats and 2 dogs we have to feed every day. And problems that we have is that we have kittens that live in the barn, and it's not the cleanest place. So you have dust, you have hay, bugs get into the food. Sometimes in the water bowl, you wake up and there's a frog in it the next day. We have cats that stay out on the front porch. You know, sometimes, no matter how many traps you set out, there's always raccoons trying to get their food. And then we have a cat that's old. We have to feed it special wet food because she eats really slowly. But all the other cats like the wet food, so they try to steal it. So if you try to close the garage door, keep her in there, but then eventually she has to come back out. And then on the inside, we have two dogs. One is super food motivated. The other just wants to play with the ball. She just wants to see if you go outside and throw her the ball. And the one that wants to just go outside and play has a skin allergy. So we have to feed her. We have to give her medicine when we feed her. And the other one that's food motivated just wants to eat all of her food. So we have to monitor them the entire time we feed them. And this goes on every single day. So we have all these problems. And one way we thought that we could address them was by developing an RFID selective feeder. So the concept is a container that would house a food bowl for either food or water for a pet, most often a dog or a cat. And the collar that the dog or cat would wear would have a specified RFID chip in it, inlaid within the collar, that'll open the lid, allow the pet to eat out of the bowl, and then close the lid once the pet is done eating. All right, so what this gives the customer is it solves a lot of the issues where you don't have toddlers getting into the food, you don't have pets fighting over territorial issues, you don't have issues with trying to regulate the diets, and it's also a portable device because it's battery operated. And on the outside world, you don't have food getting contaminated, you don't have to worry about going to the vet so often because you got bugs in your food, you got contaminated water. So how great is the greatest product if there's nobody there to buy it? So in the United States, we found that there's 79.7 million homes that own pets. 33% have multiple dogs, 55% have multiple cats. That leaves you with 79 million pets with the potential for territorial food competition. So there's a lot of pets and a lot of households, but the market for the pet industry is actually a $66.75 billion industry as of 2016, according to the APPA, which is the American Pet Product Association. We see the landscape, if we evaluate it, we see that the primary expenditures are upon food, supplies, and veterinary care, which are domains that we find marketable for our product. The growth of the pet industry, we've seen increase linearly and doubling in size almost every 10 years. So where we fit into the equation is we would like to sell our product at stores like PetSmart and Petco, where you'd expect to buy pet products, pair and get partnerships with food companies and associations with veterinary and pet product associations. But also, if you're not a person that has these issues, you probably know somebody with one. So this makes a great gift, something that you would buy at Target, Kohl's, any retail store, you buy this for somebody for as a gift. So there's products that exist in the market that range between $60 and $200 that are similar to ours, but we find that ours stands out because the one on the right is the $60, the low-end product. Lots of failures in the design. The tag is not inlaid within the collar, so a lot of times the pets, if the tag swivels around, cannot access the food. And then the one on the left uses the microchip that you would have to have implanted within your cat. So it only works with cats, it doesn't work with dogs also, and it's a $200 product, so not within the range for most viable products. Given the products that we've used to make a prototype, we've seen that a $75 price point is where we'd ideally hit, knowing how much our products costed and how much potential we have to save with them. And Mateo here would like to demonstrate how our prototype currently is working.
So I'm going to be demonstrating our prototype. Right here we have basically a cat or an animal that doesn't have the correct RFID tag. Right here is the correct RFID tag. So if the wrong animal comes up to the bowl, nothing opens. Now if the right animal comes to the bowl, the lid opens. And then we have a delay so that it will always send out a signal to see if the animal is still in front of the bowl to stay open. And if, let's say, the animal gets up, raises its head to look around or play with the ball or whatever, you have about 5 seconds for the lid to close, so that way it doesn't close on the animal or spook the animal.
that is our Shark Tank pitch.